I could not really find any concise, focused material. Is that why don't I write a Q&A book?
We're pleased to have Dr. Nabil Azhar today with us to talk about his book, Focus on Clinical Neurophysiology and Neurology Self-Assessment for the Clinical Neurophysiology Board. Dr. Azhar finished his medical school in the American University of Beirut in Lebanon, and he did his neurology residency at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. Then he moved to Vanderbilt University to do his epilepsy and clinical neurophysiology fellowships, and he was appointed there as an associate professor for neurology, and he was the program director for epilepsy at that time, and he did train multiple and dozens of doctors and professionals in epilepsy and clinical neurophysiology. He is a very well-published author, and he authored two books of epilepsy and clinical neurophysiology board review. So we're pleased to have Dr. Azhar with us to talk about his experience in writing this book and all the tips and tools for you to pass the clinical neurophysiology board. Thank you so much for joining us today to talk about your wonderful book. And so I did study this book in my clinical neurophysiology exam. So I would love to hear about your experience. And first of all, let's talk, why did you write this book? What made you author this book at the first place?
Yeah, I'm glad that you like the book. So the idea to create this focus on clinical neurophysiology came actually very spontaneously during my preparation for the clinical neurophysiology board when I was still a second year fellow at Vanderbilt University. So during my preparation for the board, I could not really find any concise, focused material for which any candidate can revert to. So I got the idea, it's like, okay, since I'm looking into different references that are thick, big, large, and may not be focused, is that why don't I write a Q&A book that could help future candidates who are sitting for this board?
Well, that's excellent. So what made you think about this Q&A format? Because lots of books can like either write narration or light Q&A or even a hybrid of those. So what made you like pick specifically the Q&A format of this book?
Right. So exactly my idea was to really do something that's concise and to the point. And the idea was that embedded in the questions and mostly the answers that follow, actually, I could tackle different angles of the same subject. So instead of really going through the routine standard chapters that could sometimes be lengthy and boring, the idea was to make it more of a board template. And from these questions, the answers can cover different angles of this question and basically be complete or comprehensive in a way to the subject of interest.
I think when I was studying the book, like asking the question will kind of like spark in my mind, this information, I did not really know it by heart, or this is like, oh, interesting point of view. So yeah, I think like when I read the question and answer, it kind of like puts more information, like on a more perspective to the information. Tell me about your secret. Like, how did you come up with this like very concise and focused book? So what made you like concise this book and make it small and such a consumable book and readable and finishable? Other books are 500 plus pages, and your book is 250 pages. So What is the secret?
Yeah, again, I think the major concern that I had is when I was preparing for this board, it was pretty difficult to find anything concise. And this is more of a subspecialty board in which fellows basically, or after training physicians, don't have the luxury of time to go over long books and looking into major references. So I don't think, I mean, I'm not sure if it's a secret, but the recipe, I would say, is like, how would I want a review book to be? And I made it the same way that I thought a review book would be beneficial, valuable, and concise. And that was the whole idea, basically. I was looking for something like that. And I said to myself, okay, why don't I do make it myself? That was the whole idea, basically.
See, you basically answered the question yourself. That's a pretty smart idea to do. When I was going over your book and doing the exam, usually the exam happens in a very unique and maybe difficult place in our lives. So you just finished your training, you're moving on to start your job, you're just like packing your house and moving around, and then you don't have like lots of time to start and read the and study the materials for the exam. So having a real small book that would be giving you all the information that is necessary for the exam, I think it's very helpful. So if you want to tell me, Did you leave anything out when we made this smaller size book, or how did you consider everything in that book?
I tried to include everything that is related to the board exam, and remembering well, I went over the syllabus that they sent you, the content mm-hmm. syllabus, trying to be as complete as possible in regard to the focus points that are included in the exam. I mean, in no way this review book replaces the large reference books, you know, but it has one aim, is to prepare candidates for the clinical neurophysiology board. It may not be 100% complete, but based on many reviews and feedback, it feels to me that it covers most of the subjects that show up in the exam.
Yeah, that's right. So for advice to our fellows who are sitting for this exam, we have most of the clinical neurophysiology fellowships. We have a split track, which we do 6 EEG, 6 months of EMG. So it's kind of fairly trained in both. But we have lots of people who do like 9 months of EMG, and then they do 2 months or even like 1 month of EEG, and then the vice versa. So people who are like so focused on epilepsy, like myself, I did 10 months of EEG and then 2 months of EMG that I chose to do. So how can you advise our fellows to study and use your book to kind of fill in their gaps that they did not study well for or like did not get trained for?
Sure, you know, and that's the issue with it. Clinical neurophysiology initial certification is that it kind of divides it almost equally between EEG, EMG, and the rest adds some of the intraoperative monitoring or some sleep and some of the physics that pertains to the subject. So the way I would say, you know, I myself directed the fellowship program at Vanderbilt for several years, and I'm very familiar with the fellowship program that entails clinical neurophysiology. So my suggestion or my recommendation is to start first with the subjects that the candidate is less confident with, and then with the remaining time, just try to have a review over the other subjects in which they have more experience in. So if someone is more EEG oriented during the clinical neurophysiology year, I would recommend starting and putting more time on the EMG part, nerve conduction part, the other parts, and then for the remaining time, go back to the EEG and epilepsy on the clinical epilepsy section of the book.
Yeah, that's excellent. And how about the physics part, like those transistors and capacitors and you know, like the things that only sometimes physicists will understand, but we really, as a neurophysiologist and who people deal with those machines and those tests, how would you advise our candidates and people who are doing this test to kind of prepare for this subject that sometimes it's kind of difficult to grasp well and do on the exam?
Correct. And this is very a little bit abstract. We don't see it when we perform EEG, when we read EEGs, when we treat patients. We don't see that, basically. But this is real physics behind it. really realize the whole EEG system or concept. So I think in that focused book, this section, I think, is the most focused of it all, because it does not really go over lots of details, but it just tries to give in the answer section what a regular or an average fellow would need to know to answer a question without going into the deeps of or depth of I would say of physics, which could be pretty labor intensive and challenging, especially at our level.
I think that's totally correct, and I see it from experience. As I'm an associate program director for clinical neurophysiology, and our fellows always kind of like feels a little dry to study those subjects, and you know, like it's physics. So unless you have like MD/PhD on your resume, usually you're not like a pro in this. But yeah, if you understand like the basic concepts of physics and those transistors and how the differential amplifiers works, then you can get away with what you need in the exam. All right, so well, that's excellent points for our fellows and our candidates that are going through this exam. What other final points would you like to make on this subject?
So I would say, I think this review book is due for some facelift a little bit of a second edition. It has been a project in my mind, but it hasn't really materialized yet due to time constraints, I would say, mostly. I hope that I'll have the time luxury to update that. In the near future.
I think that is something that we all are waiting for, the second edition of this Red Book. And I really love, you know, I rubbed my experience, and I was gifted this book when I did my fellowship program so that I can study it. So it is an invaluable book, and I would really love to see the second edition coming in. And I did like the fact that you made an online subscription with the book. So mm-hmm. I don't have to carry the book around. Sometimes if I'm, you know, like sitting there somewhere, I have like a half an hour in the hospital, can I like just log in and do the study? And that was like really handy for me when like to have an online subscription that you can log in anywhere, anytime, and just study that.
Right. So again, that goes to the same idea, is not much time. How can we use the time most efficiently to pass the board? And actually the publisher, they were kind enough to offer this extra gadget in it.
Yeah, I think we really appreciate that. Well, that's very good. And thank you so much for being with us and sharing your experience and on this very, very important book, the focus on clinical neurophysiology. And we wish all of our candidates the best of luck in their exam.
Thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome. Thank you so much.